One and all. Today I wanted to take this subject much further. I wanted to explain the very subject about what could be the thing that happens after death. Even before understanding what is it that happens after death, we need to understand what happens during our very life existence on this earth. The point is, I wanted to touch upon this because as I was speaking about conscious, subconscious, semi-conscious, subconscious mind during the yoga practice, there is something called pranayama, wherein inhale and exhale happens, during which our body gets lightened. In the sense, like, it would be, our body would get lightened the moment you start getting into the trance level, which is one very point which one needs to understand. This is what is called the real meaning of yoga, and this is what is called the space and time travel. Yo plus ga, yoga. Now the very point which forced or which triggered me to do this video was, I had three major or four major incidents which I came across in my life. Meaning, it was a literal, like, exact experience, I would rather say. One was my uncle's death. Other was my aunt's death. Both of these deaths were untimely deaths. When I say untimely, they seized that death opportunity and took that opportunity and finished their journey on this earth. Let's not talk about the philosophy, let's not talk about the spirituality, let's not talk about it. The other very point, the other death, was my aunt's death, who was suffering from cancer. She was hospitalized. She was on ventilators for quite some time. I incidentally had an opportunity to go to an hospital and see that environment. I was so petrified. I was, like, quite moved with that. And I had typical questions of what really happens at a subconscious level and conscious level in today's time, if I really look at. and the fourth death. During my childhood, when I was going to school, I was seeing a person who was driving the scooter, met with an accident. Not accident exactly, he was going. But there was a sharp, there was a sharp blade like thing which cut the head, neck and crop for no reason. And that's the end. Like this, I had seen one more, wherein I had seen eyes coming out, etc., etc., etc. Now, when I was like looking, going through Vedas, Upanishads, Upavedas, if I really go through Garuda Purana or whatever it is, these scriptures, what really is that one thing that really happens to the human body? Why these things happen at first place? Why these thoughts come at first place? What really is that one thing that triggers? At the same time, I had seen my grandfather who demised in sleep. My grandmother, who was really very good, hale and healthy, but by the time she reached 50 or 60 or maybe 70 plus, she was not knowing what to do. Her senses were lost. Why does this happen? On contrary, I had seen one lady who was 94 years old. My grandfather was 74 years. He demised in the sleep after folding a whole of the clothes and all. I want to go to sleep. That was the last sleep that he had. That's it. And there was the one other lady who used to read Vedic texts, scriptures, etc., etc. Even before her demise, she read the text, slept, that was the last. At the same time, Kalam sir, who gave the last speech in IIM Shillong, he delivered that knowledge before leaving and just fell down. That's the last. And there was one more death which I had seen, which went viral. One bank manager. He was speaking and speaking and speaking. Bas. Finish. What really is that happens? If I really take the first few cases and these cases, the later cases, what really is that one thing that really did them to get to this state where they died a peaceful death? My father's death. He had a last laugh. He had a sumptuous food to his happiness. which was auspicious day, some dish food, and he went inside and he was just doing his bedding work and all. Blood got clotted, finish. What really is that thing that really happened with these later cases in these cases? Before even getting to all of this, which I have got to your notice, let's try understanding the before death experience, before death happenings. My own mother, who is pious lady, who does all kinds of rituals and all, I remember, which I got it as an inheritance, fortunately. She is in a state where she is not able to understand, she is in a confusion state of mind. In her subconscious mind or conscious mind. And she is in her own world. She was in her own world. She wanted certain things to happen in her own way. That's a different aspect altogether. Because every individual has his or her own reservations. Likewise, I had seen some of the cases where I see like people shouting. They say that is due to the Amavasya or the full moon coming nearer. By the by, it's no joke. All these are practical realities, and these are the philosophical or the, you know, the cosmic, highest level of understanding of the cosmic energy levels that really affect one's mind. Be it my mother's case, be it my aunt's case, be it my uncle's case, be it anybody who is on ventilators for 20 days, S.P. Balasubramanian sir, who was on ventilators for quite some time. He left the mortal coils. All of these, if you really look at, if you understand, the first few cases which I was talking about on the ventilators part, or the one who is on ventilators, one who is like, you know, whose head was chopped off, or one who has died in plane crash, etc., etc. There is something called perception that happens deep within our body. Deep within our body, which we need to understand. Though this is the highest level of understanding, the highest level of human intellect, which one needs to understand to the core. When I say to the core, to the core. If you are practicing that genuinely, selflessly, be it parents, be it your siblings, be it your relations, be it anyone. Relationship doesn't matter over here. Which is what we need to understand over here. The crux of the subject is our very human existence, the moment it comes down to earth, that is the material world, it comes empty-minded in the sense empty-minded, totally empty. What happens is we fill it with garbage and all nonsense kind of thoughts, and we tend to get to many kinds of thoughts, useless thoughts that come into our mind and start filling it with it. The moment we fill it with, we fill that, you know, fill that substance or the very thoughts in our mind starts working towards it. Our brain starts programming. A kind of programming starts happening in our subconscious mind or the conscious mind. This very thing happens right from your a very younger age of fifth year or third year. Because between third year and sixth year, you tend to see the parents or someone who is trying to guide you. The very primary people who guide you are your parents, not the society. Because the moment you get up in your house, you will see your parents' actions. That's what gets registered in your subconscious or conscious mind. Understand this. The moment that is done, this individual, be it male or female, so-called son or a daughter, starts filling that in his or her subconscious mind. And this happens even with the child who is born in the mother's womb, mother seeing her mother or father, son seeing his mother or his father, father seeing his mother or father. Like this, this clan starts from the forefathers or the ancestral kind of thing. So the very cause for all of these apathies or whatever that is happening for a person, be it untimely death, be it some kind of issues, some kind of problems happening at an older age or whatever it is, happens and grows. These are the prime reasons where one really misses. Today, the generation that we are seeing is not understanding this to the core. I wanted to do an analysis on this as to what really happens. This is what I felt. When I come to the case study of a lady who was 94 years, who died a peaceful death. She followed that curriculum, she followed that structure till the very last moment of death, having her mind, subconscious mind or conscious or conscious, semi-subconscious mind, always purified, nullifying and, you know, zeroing it out on the negative thoughts from her mind. And she always kept it filled with positive mindset till the very last moment. My grandfather, who died a peaceful death. All of us like this, if I really look at, need to understand the very functionality or the technicality of how to use our conscious or subconscious or semi-subconscious or conscious mind. This is a very important aspect which every one of us need to understand. Yoga doesn't mean just mere practicing of asanas or whatever it is. Even the dance form that you are seeing, classical dance, it is not a mere dance. You need to understand the practical reality, ground reality behind doing those steps. So-called jatis, jatiswaras, tilanas, mudras, etc., etc. How they help you to reprogram or realign or re-engineer your thoughts. Today I was getting forced to do this video for the further extension of what I spoke in my previous video, which talks about the human existence. I was talking about exigency factor. This is what is called exigency factor. If one says due to the karmic deeds these things are happening, no. Leave aside Garuda Purana or whatever it is. Let's not talk about the spirituality aspect over here. What are the actions that you did? From my 12th year or from my 13th year, I have been thinking about why this apathy happens. Everyone had a deaf fear, that's all. Nobody wanted to understand. That's okay for me. I am not getting into highest spiritual level or I am not getting into highest philosophical level. I am trying to be more clear with my thought process at a deeper level. Understanding from the conscious state of mind. Conscious, subconscious, super subconscious, semi-subconscious mind. How do I be that regenerated person or re-engineered person? It's not about the relationship or whatever thoughts or whatever they say. they send or whatever quotes, that's a different aspect. Being a karma yogi is not again an issue here over here. We need to understand this. And doing rituals is not a kind of thing. Doing upavasa also is not a kind of thing. Going to temple and doing that namaskar is also not a thing over here. When you do namaskar, you do it this way, coming over here on the chest like this. And we have one mudra, this mudra, which we do. And this, this, and this, and this, like this. What really all of this mean? You are unifying your conscious, subconscious, semi-subconscious, subconscious, super subconscious mind. For the one who is practicing or doing meditation by way of rituals or whatever it is, what I have seen is till date, today I will be turning 46 this year, that we people do it just for the heck of doing, thinking that I need this, I need that, I need this, I need that. Whole my life I have seen people expecting this. Because I have served in, I did a free service in super specialty hospital. I did services for Ayyappa for almost like 4 years, doing that Abhisheka and all. For 8 months, 3 months, 4 months, I have cleaned temple premises when I was doing my degree. The only thing that I have understood is, it is how you tame your conscious, subconscious, super subconscious, semi-subconscious mind. Coming to after death, I don't think so. You can really think about it. Because whatever that they are showing in YouTube or whatever it is, I don't think so it's legitimate. Or it has any meaning in that, to be honest. Because there are many scholars who are working on that. In fact, to share one anecdote, when my father demised, before the body was taken, or before the body was actually like taken to the cremation place, I tried to see if body had any movement. In fact, it had. It doesn't respond. The only thing is soul will go, but that mind, in mind, the left and right brain stays intact till the time you burn that body. I had observed that. in my father's body. People say body will be dead. No. Even when the lungs and other things fail, everything, the left and right brain, whatever brain, mind is there, it will be dead, though it is brain dead, but still it will have life for 2 or 3 hours. This is one of the major observations that I had. In my aunt's case, when I went there, she was not able to speak, but she was able to write. When I visited her, sorry about that, after coming out of the hospital and when she was at her home, when she was not responding, still she had that, you know, senses working. I had one case where an 86-year-old lady who was in her last stages, she was not able to open her eyes. Eyes were very frail. Everything was actually like blur for her. But still, she was able to move her body like this. And her body lasted for maybe half an hour or 1 hour after that. My own uncle, who was hale and healthy, he suffered with a major disease. I wouldn't cancer kind of disease. He was not able to move, he was not able to talk, but still he was able to move. What really is this, all of this? If I really look at all of these cases, it is the conscious, subconscious, semi-conscious, subconscious mind that works towards this. Understand this. It is how you program that. It is how you fill your mind. That is the reason why they say if body, mind and soul is under control, even in your last stages, you will be a better off person. You will die a peaceful death. But you need to follow certain rituals or certain structured approach. Think about it. This is a very important point which one needs to understand in his or her life, which I feel is very important. Believe me. Mark my words. Think about it. Think about it. Have a nice day ahead. May the Guru's grace be with all. Shri Guru Purnama.